Hey, welcome back. It may be time not only to socially distance, but to cognitively distance. Epictetus said, "It's not things that upset us, but rather our opinions about things." Aaron Beck was a psychotherapist who helped pioneer what is called CBT, or cognitive behavioral therapy, which is widely used and accepted today by psychologists. And one of the approaches that he would take with his clients or his patients when they had a false belief that was bringing them angst and problems in their lives was to ask them, "What evidence do you have of this?" And it would give them pause to step back and look to say, "Why do I believe this?" Another analogy that he would use would be sunglasses. So if you wear rose-tinted sunglasses, you're going to see the world through rose-colored glasses, as the saying goes. But if you wear dark sunglasses, and I've done this sometimes and I've had to remove them, you begin to see the world as dark and foreboding. It's a place that maybe is unwelcoming. It's your perspective. It's not the world that's outside of those glasses. So here are three ways that you can begin to practice cognitive distancing, which is extremely important because we're facing not only economic upheaval, but we're also seeing civil unrest around the nation, big changes. So how we keep ourselves grounded and healthy internally is increasingly important. Number one is to play the role of an observer. You remember the movie Midway, where they had the reconnaissance planes flying out? They were looking for the Japanese fleet, and they were merely just seeing what was happening. Their job was to observe and then report. If we take that role and just separate ourselves for just a moment and get up to that 10,000 foot view, we can remove ourselves a little bit more and begin to think about what's really happening rather than feeling what it is to be down in the thick of it. Number two, and this is one of my favorites, is to flip the script around. Instead, ask yourself this: what advice would I give my very best friend in this same situation? How would I tell him or her that they may be able to look at this? Third is to realize what your locus of control is. That is your sphere of control. If you want a really interesting study, look up locus of control, by the way. And fourth, a bonus tip is your thoughts are not who you are. Thoughts are just that. They're things that fly in and they fly out. It's what you do day in and day out that defines who you are as a person. So hopefully these tips help. Not only practicing social distancing, but cognitive distancing is going to become increasingly important. I hope this will find you healthy and well, and you're both in your personal and business life. Leave your comments below on how you've helped separate yourself from maybe an unpleasant situation and get your perspective back on track. Please share this video, if you would, with other professionals. You can do that using the social media links on this page. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you here next week. Have a great weekend.